Welcome to everyone. So today in this video, we will discuss about the French colonialism in Vietnam. Then we will discuss about the real motive of French over Vietnam, civilizing mission of French, and divide and rule policy of French, and the economic transformation of Vietnam. So first of all, I would like to tell you that first we need to understand that the decision to invade in Vietnam was first made by the Napoleon III in July 1857. So it was the result not only of machinery propaganda, but also after 1850 of the upsurge of French capitalism, which generated the need for the overseas markets. And the overseas markets could be the Asian market, African market. They want more supremacy and hold over the Asian and African continent. So the desire for a larger French share of the Asian territories conquered by the West. So French colonialism in Vietnam lasted more than 6 decades. By the late 1880s, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia were all controlled by France and collectively referred to as French Indochina. Indochina became one of France's most important colonial possessions. French colonialism was focused largely on production, profit, and the labor. The main aim was the French for the production, profit, and the labor. So it had a profound impact on the lives of people in Vietnam. So what is the civilizing mission? Basically, mission civilizing was a thin facade just for the false appearance, and the real motive for French colonialism was profit and the economic exploitation. French imperialism was driven by a demand for resources, raw materials, and the cheap labor. The development of colonized nation was scarcely considered except where it happened to just only for the French interests. So what were the role of French governors? French governors were highly corrupt officials at that time, and they had significant autonomy, authority, and power. And it also considered that they just served for the interest of the French. What about the policy of divide and rule? So to minimize the local resistance, the French employed a divide and rule strategy, undermining the Vietnamese unity by playing local mandarins, communities, and religious groups against each other. Under French colonial rule, there was no national identity or authority in Vietnam or its neighbors, like other third world countries. The workers on plantation in French Indochina were known as coolies, a derogatory term for Asian laborers. They worked long hours in debilitating conditions for wages that were pitifully small. Some were paid in rice rather than money. So now the how economy of Vietnam transformed to the modern economy and how they were exploited. Basically, economic transformation, profit not politics, was the driving force behind the French colonization. Over time, colonial officials and French companies transformed Vietnam's thriving subsistence economy. Subsistence economy means not market oriented, that was just for oneself, into the proto-capitalist system based on land ownership, increased production, exports, and low wages. So now the harsh system of French income tax on wages, high on the liberals, role of local officials and bureaucrats to maintain the stability in Vietnam. But after the decolonization process, except the educational transformation, traditionals, local temples, pagodas, monuments, buildings were destroyed, and the buildings of French architecture and style were erected in their place.